Hi all, I'm back. So what we're going to talk about in this video, we're going to start with MP chart. We're going to talk about how to develop MP charts or charts for attribute control charts for defective items when the or when the sample size is inconsistent. MP chart. So let's look into the slide.
All right, so this is a slide for MP charts. Okay, so let me put in the slide show. So where we are now, we are, as it mentions in my last video, we are at last parts of our modules talking about attribute control charts. We have done all of the chapters except attribute control charts. So the first control charts that we're going to discuss now is MP charts. For those that yet to watch my previous video, your advice to watch the video before you start watching this video. Not perhaps you are not able to get the idea of what MP chart is. So for those who have watched the previous video, I think you should have a better understanding where MP chart is applied when the quality characteristic is attributes, counting, and the nature of the inspection method is to detect defective items and when the sample size is consistent, and that is the scenario or condition that we should apply MP chart. So I did explain this in the last video. When it comes to defective items, the result inspection of defective item will be only two, if either pass or fail. Okay, so you categorize the inspections item in the two category, either it's pass or fail. Example that we discussed in last video was the production line of mineral water. So the inspection, the result of the inspection is either pass or fail. Pass means mineral water with water, and fail means empty bottle mineral water. And why you call it attribute is because at the end of the day, we're going to count. You're not going to calculate, no? You're going to count how many bottle is empty. Okay, so that's why we call it attribute and defective item. And this is another example, inspections of the screw, is it? They call it bolt. It's the same thing, so to inspect. And the inspection result will be either pass or fail. And you are collecting the inspection plan that we learned in variable control chart and sampling plan still the same. The method of inspection is you have to collect a subgroup. And example, the subgroup that in this example, the subgroup size 15, and out of the 15, two are defective. Okay, so this is a scenario of the this is the scenario that we will apply MP charts. MP charts apply when the subgroup size is consistent, or the sample size is consistent. Not subgroup size, it's a sample size is consistent. Means when you start picking up the sample. Okay, before I go further, there are two things that I discussed earlier also in the last video. N equal to the sampling size, MP referring to defective item. So the nature of MP chart is, or when you apply MP chart, when the natural inspection is N is consistent. I repeat, my sentence is a bit confusing, right? Okay. You should apply MP charts when the sample size of inspection is consistent. What does it mean? It means that every time we pick out a sample, the number of samples you pick from the productions is consistent. And what's MP mean? MP is the number of defects that you number of defects means defective items that you detect or you inspected from each sample subgroup, from each subgroup. So here we have three subgroups. Subgroup 1, subgroup 2, subgroup 3. And each subgroup you have consistent number of sample, 4, 4, 4. MP is referring to out of the 4 sample that you pick, how many rejected. In the first scenario, there's none of the parts rejected. The second scenario, there are 2. So MP equal to 2. The third scenario, there's 1. Therefore, MP equal to 1. So this is the condition, or this is this is a scenario that you should apply MP charts. Consistent sample size. Okay, consistent sample size. And as per usual, when I say usual means referring to X by R chart. In order to construct or develop a control chart, there are 3 fundamental lines that you need to identify. The first one is the center line. The second one is upper control limit, and the third one is lower control limit. And what shown in the slide is the formula of how to derive center line, upper control limit, and lower control limit. Okay, so remember we discussed MP is number of defective items. Right? So the sum of number of defective items, example, if I have 10 subgroups, so I put up the number of defective items from all the 10 subgroups. How many rejected in the layman term? We say that out of the 10 subgroups, how many items rejected? So that's a sum of MP. Number of subgroups, because I'm saying that I'm picking from 10 subgroups, so number of subgroups if you go to 10, okay, in my example, if you go to 10, and MP, sum of MP means out of the 10 subgroups, in total, how many items rejected. So, divided the sum of MP with number of subgroups, if you will get the center line of the control chart, and that's what we call MPO. Okay, or MP node. I call it MPO better. So 10 is only the example, not necessarily, it depends on number of subgroups. By now you should be able to differentiate between sample size and number of subgroups. If this is the inspection plan, number of subgroups is 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, sample size is 4. So in this case, the sum of defective item of this case is equal to 0 plus 2 plus 1. You get me? Alright. So that is center line. How about upper control limit? Upper control limit is equal to MPO. MPO, where you get MPO? MPO you get from here. Okay. Plus 3 multiplied by square root of MPO. Okay, multiplied by 1 minus PO. 1 minus PO, what is PO? PO is equal to the sum of defective items. Same as this one. But however, this time, it's still divided by the number of subgroups. You are divided by the total number of samples. Okay. What does it mean? For this example, the total number of subgroup is 3. Okay. So number of subgroup for that example is equal to 3. The example that I showed earlier. The total number of sample for the example that I showed you earlier, this one, is equal to 4 + 4 + 4, mean 12. So by knowing this formula, then you can calculate the center line, upper control limit, and lower control limit. That's why I did mention in last video, I'm saying that the methods of developing a center line, upper control limit, and lower control limit for every single chart that we discussing and we're going to discuss, MP chart, P chart, C chart, and U chart, is quite straightforward. Was easy lah, was kacang lah. So the difficulty, in fact, it's not so difficult. If given a scenario, what type of chart that you should propose? That's the one that perhaps you need to focus more. Huh? All right. So by saying so, let's take a look on the example here. Why you look at this? I have n number of sample. I have np. Defective items. So if I ask you to develop a control chart, yeah, you will develop the MP chart now, because all the while there's no chart that you have learned besides MP chart. But if I ask you a question that in this scenario, why you develop MP charts? The reason you use MP chart, why you should use MP chart. The reason that you should use MP chart is because the sample size is consistent. Correct? It's consistent. Huh? Okay. So in this case there are 25 subgroups, and each subgroup make up 300 sample. Okay, and the number of defective items MP is also summarized in the table. And in this example, a total number of defective items across the 25 subgroup is 131. How you get 131? When you total up this number, you should get 131. The total of the MP across all the 25 subgroup, you should get 131. Therefore, center line MPO is equal to total defective item divided by number of subgroup. So, okay, never mind, I show everything. So the number of defective item is 131. And the number of subgroup is 131, and number of subgroup is 25. Therefore, look at this one first, like MP1. MP1 is equal to 131 divided by 25, because you have, and then 31 in total, you have 25 subgroup, right? And you get 5.24. How about PO? PO, sometimes you also call it P bar. If I put 2. Okay. One thing that you might confuse, in statistics, is different book using different symbol. Okay, there's, I try to put every single symbol there so you won't confuse in case you refer to different book. So as we discussed earlier, PO or P bar is equal to the total defective item divided by the total sample. So the total defective item is same as is here, 131. How about the total sample? We know that there's 25 subgroup, and every subgroup make up the 300 sample. So it's 25 times 300, and you get 0.01746. Take a look on the formula. Now you have calculated MPO, MPO. Okay. Take a look on the formula. Once you have calculated MPO, where's my pen? MPO, 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 then you're able to calculate the upper control limit and lower control limit. Very straightforward. And replacing the MPO, MPO by the calculation that you've done earlier on, you will get upper control limit equal to 12. Okay, you can calculate by yourself and see how. And lower control limit is equal to negative. But bear in mind attribute when you do counting, how many pen you have. You can't sort of give me an answer that I have negative 1.5. Like, correct. Why? Number one, attribute without negative. Number two, attribute without 0.5. No decimal. Must be a solid number. So therefore, you have to change to zero. Okay, bring to the nearest integer number. Okay, and that's it. You have 0 and 12. And then next we're going to do is you do the same thing that what you did in SPC, plot the upper control and lower control. And if you see you're plotting the upper control, lower control, and center line, plotting the point. Where are you going to get the point? In order to get this point, you see, you have this raw data. Where are you going to get the point in order for the plots on the MP charts? Are you going to put 3, 6, 4? No. Is it? Okay. This is the point that you're going to put. 3, 6, 4, 9, 20. You're going to plot this point. Right? So 3, 6, 9, 3, 5, 6, 20. So you discover that there's one point that our specification limit. There's another point that perhaps on lower spec limit, is it? But in lower spec limits. But okay, so this why this is not in red? This is a very interesting point, and this is the main one, the difference between attributes and variable. Okay. Zero, do you want to investigate this one? You're not going to answer me. Okay, I'll come back to this later. Here. There's one point that above upper control limit. So the next course of action you need to do is you have to investigate. So then you must able to power the root cause, and then once it's done, then you can remove this point. You can remove this point from the control chart, and you need to replot. When it comes to replot, means you take out data from. You take out data number 5. You take out data number 5, example here. Then your subgroup size will remain 24. Okay, 24. And here your MP will become 111. And using this number, you will calculate your MPO, PO, and your upper control limit, lower control limit, and regenerate the MP chart. Okay, that is quite standard, same as what we did in X bar R charts. How about here? Back to these questions. We have 1 point, 2 point that on lower control limit. Should you go investigate? You're not able to answer me. You're very lucky, right? So you don't need to answer, right? You're just listening. So the answer is no, no investigation. Why no investigation required? I'm not going to answer in, okay, I decided initially I thought I want to tell you lah, but I feel that unfair that like I'm talking, you have no chance to talk. So I'm not going to answer, I'm not going to explain to you why, but you try to think why. If this is an X by R chart, then we should investigate. But since this is an MP chart, from process control perspective, like I'm going to investigate, but not as what I did in X by R chart. It's okay, I think. I will explain. I changed my mind again. Right? Okay. You're not going to investigate the root cause, why zero? Because zero defect item means it's good. Am I right? You're not going to investigate this. Zero defect item means lot 10 and a batch number 10 and batch 20. 10 and 20, let's take a look. 10 out of the 300 samples they pick, none of defective items, and 20 as well. Are you going to investigate the root cause? We are trying to find a root cause when there's a reset. When there's no reset, why are you going to find a root cause? You're not going to find a root cause. So you're not going to investigate to find a root cause. Instead, perhaps you could investigate to see what has been done or what is the process setting, who is operator on at the point that you're collecting sample of subgroup 10 and 20. And that will give you an idea that that setting or that operator perhaps is the best setting and best operator of the process. Then you can solve that. Observe if the example you notice that you're picking up the sample for 25 times, and on day number 10, we call it day number 10 and day number 20, there's no defective item. And you go and solve investigate, then you notice that 10 and 20 is the machine is running by the same operator. And these are the only two there that this operator running the machine. Then give you idea that he or she is the best operator, and you try to sort of like observe how the operator operating the machine and make a standard operating procedure or operating the machine. Develop a standard operating procedure of operating machine based on how the operator is operating the machine. Then that's another way of improving the process. So in summary, I'm saying that in MP chart, most likely you're going to get lower control limits of zero. So if there's a point on that, then don't worry, because that's a good indication. And this perhaps answer a question raised by one of the students, right? When I was discussing variable control charts, a student did send me a message asking me this, if lower, smaller, then better. I told him that don't worry, you bear with me, I'm going to discuss this in attribute chart. This is the point. In attribute, because we are counting, so if you count the defective, there's zero defective, that's good, no problem. But when it comes to measurement, no. Measurement, no. Doesn't mean that smaller is better. Huh? Okay. All right. So that's it for MP charts. And as for which tutorial you need to do and where you're going to submit a tutorial, then you should refer to my, you should refer to e-learning. I'll put a note there to tell you then which one that you should which tutorial you should do and where to submit. Okay, so that's all I have in for today, MP chart, or for this chapter, MP chart. Quite straightforward, okay? And then see you in next chapter again. Bye.